Hey guys, and welcome back to Crouton Cracker Jacks. Today, I'm going to show you how to make delicious chocolatey and fudgy crinkle cookies. These cookies are crunchy around the edges, soft and fudgy and gooey in the middle, covered in powdered sugar. They are just absolutely incredibly delicious, and they're super easy to make. So without further ado, let me show you how to make them. So for this recipe, you're going to need 1 cup of plain or all-purpose flour, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 cup of Dutch processed cocoa, 1 cup of white granulated sugar, 1/4 cup of vegetable oil or an unflavored oil, 2 large eggs, and 1 teaspoon of vanilla. And you're also going to need about 1/2 cup of powdered sugar. So the first thing I'm going to do is get my dry ingredients together. I've got my 1 cup of all-purpose flour here. I'm going to add in my baking powder as well as my salt. And using a fork, I'm just going to mix this together so that way when I add this to the wet ingredients, I don't get any lumps of baking powder or salt in the finished dough. Once you get that mixed up, you want to go ahead and set it off to the side. Next, in a large bowl, I'm going to add in my sugar as well as my cocoa powder. Now, I am using a Dutch processed cocoa powder here, which is the better tasting cocoa powder. Using a whisk, I'm just going to whisk these two ingredients together. It'll allow the cocoa powder to mix into our final batter a lot better by mixing it in with the sugar first. Try and get any lumps out. But if you can find Dutch processed cocoa, definitely go with that. It gives a much richer chocolatey flavor to your finished cookie. And to this mix, I'm going to add in my vegetable oil, and I'm just going to mix this together. Now, this isn't going to, you know, become a liquid. It's going to be kind of sandy and gritty. That's perfectly fine, but you want to make sure to use an unflavored oil for this. Vegetable oil, corn oil, canola oil. Do not use olive oil because your cookies will taste like olives and not what you want. Now, once all your sugar and cocoa powder has become moistened with the oil, you can go ahead and add in your 2 large eggs as well as your 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. And again, using a whisk, I'm going to whisk this mixture together. Now, if you want to do this whole process in a stand mixer, you by all means can go ahead and do that. If you want to use a hand mixer, that's fine too. I'm just using a whisk for this because it's easy. Once those ingredients come together, you want to beat this for about 30 seconds or so just to make sure that all of the egg is broken up and incorporated into the sugar and cocoa powder mixture. Now is also your chance to break up any sugar lumps or clumps of cocoa powder that you may have. And then you want to add your dry ingredients to the wet ingredients. This is the flour, baking powder, and salt mixture. And I'm going to switch out to a spatula for this process. You can also use a wooden spoon. Because this dough does kind of get kind of stiff, so, you know, a whisk isn't the best tool for this. And you just want to mix this together just until the flour is incorporated into the wet ingredients. You don't want to go beating this mixture because you will develop gluten in the flour and you're going to have some tough cookies. And you want these cookies to be soft and tender. So as you're mixing this, it may look like, you know, there's too much flour in the mixture and, you know, your dough is not going to come together. Trust me, it will come together. Just keep mixing it and it'll just happen like magic that everything will come together. And you want to scrape off your spatula, and now we want to chill our dough. You don't want to bake this dough right away. It's more like a batter. So what's going to happen is it's just going to spread out all over your cookie sheet and it's just going to make a mess. You're not going to have individual cookies. So you want to cover your bowl with saran wrap and you want to refrigerate this mixture for at least 4 hours. You want to make sure that this dough gets nice and cold before you bake any cookies with it. Now that our dough is nice and chilled, we can go ahead and make up our cookies. And I am using a disher here for this. This is a number 40 disher. It's about 2 tablespoons or so. You don't have to have one of these. You can just use a couple of spoons to make little balls of dough. I'm just gonna go straight into my batter and get myself a nice scoop of cookie dough. And I'm going to place that into my bowl of powdered sugar. And basically all you're going to do is make little balls of dough and coat them with powdered sugar and put them onto a cookie sheet. Now I've lined my cookie sheet with a Silpat. You want to line it with either a Silpat or parchment paper. Don't use foil because it'll actually burn the bottom of the cookies. And you just want to place your little dough balls 3 or 4 inches apart and you want to gently flatten them out just ever so slightly before you bake them. Then you want to bake your cookies at 350 degrees for between 10 and 12 minutes. This is going to depend on your oven, how long you need to bake them for. Just keep an eye on them. When they are done, you can take them out of the oven and they will be just set in the very center of the cookie. If you press down, the cookie should give just a little tiny bit. You should be able to feel if it's done or not. And then you want to let them cool and rest on the cookie sheet until they are cool. Right now, the cookies are going to be super soft, and it's just going to make a mess if you try and remove them from your cookie sheet now, so let them chill. But there you go. That is how you make chocolatey, fudgy, gooey on the inside, crunchy on the outside chocolate crinkle cookies. I hope you guys enjoy. If you give this recipe a try, let me know how you like it down below in the comments. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe for more deliciousness and to keep up to date on all my latest videos. Check me out on Instagram and Facebook, where I post every few days. Thanks so much for watching, and we will see you next time.